Hello, FIFA faithful, Bearhams here, and welcome to episode 34 of U Squad Gods with Bayern Munich 2. Oh boy, you guys are in for a treat as we'll take a look here at the calendar. Yeah, we're going to have a lot of games as we will start out the home fixture against Tottenham Hotspur. We will simulate one game, and that is the away fixture against Eintracht Frankfurt. But then we have that second leg against Tottenham to hopefully find ourselves in the Champions League final. And then we are going to play two more games. This is going to be a four-game episode as we will take on Borussia Dortmund at home, and then we'll finish it off against the top team in the league right now, Wolfsburg, at home. So we could clinch a spot in the Champions League. We could win the Bundesliga in this episode, or we do neither. That's how it might go. Since Dudzinski played in the last game and he is dead tired, we do have to put Graf in at cam, as it's the first leg of the Champions League semifinals, and we take on Spurs. Ah, under the blue hue of this European night. Again, just 180 minutes away from finding ourselves in the Champions League final. But we got to perform first. It's very risky to have Campanucci in, but because Harry Kane is so slow, it's okay, as we might have a counter here. Cristea. Oh, he's going to get past his defender. Maybe a chance here. He's going to pass. Justice Graf takes the shot, but he's going to hit a defender. The last man we need in the box. So he's going to find him. Does find an opportunity. Will be saved by Dudzinski. And that will be the end of the first half. So far, very nervy, very timid from both sides. Though we've had a couple of chances. They've been squandered by the nerves here at Allianz Arena. So I'm hoping in the second half, maybe a switch in personnel, we can maybe get a home goal and hopefully keep this clean sheet. Oh, good interception by Siegmund. He's able to keep it in, though. Oh, good play, Schwabe. That was a very good play to just knock down Kane. Here, Anderson tries to thread that through to Graf. Graf gets tripped up. We will get a call, most likely a yellow for Mancini. Oh, my God, straight red. Perfect. This is what we want here in the second half, though. We've had our bad luck when the other team does get a red. So we're taking out Vitaly, bringing on Dudzinski. The dude in all of his glory. Oh, shoot. I wanted the other guy. Oh, there's a header. Maybe a chance. Oh, it gets tipped over by Lopez. It's now Schwabe. He'll win the header. Vera taps that through to Dudzinski. Dudzinski fresh off the bench, though not 100%. Now Graf. Oh, tap that through. Dudzinski, can he finish it? Off the bench he does. In the 88th minute, it's Mateusz, the dude Dudzinski, getting the pass and delivering at his home, Allianz Arena. Mwah. Loving the late second heroics by our Polish cam, as it is Petrojpa setting it up for Dudzinski. And we might just finish with a victory here. And move that was, as Dudzinski's just going to launch it out. Just boot it out, and that will be it. End of the first leg. We do get the victory, thanks in part to a last-second goal from Mateusz Dudzinski. Great tactics by Federico Aguilera, besting Pochettino, who it should be Mourinho. But nonetheless, good start to the semifinals. Let's see how we do at Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. Come on, come on, come on. A good result against Frankfurt. Oh, no. Yep. We lose 1-0, 66th minute. We give it to Poato. Yikes. So Wolfsburg did get the victory. So now in our league games, we really got to show up against Dortmund and Wolfsburg in order to lift the Bundesliga title. Second leg of the Champions League semifinal, we look to punch our ticket at Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. As you saw, Gori is very tired. We're just going to put him in for the first half. We'll bring on Petrojpa in the second to hopefully finish out this game. The good thing is we're away, so if we do get an away goal, they'll have to score three goals to win this. So yeah, that's simple and straightforward. Can we just get one away goal? No one's making a... Finally, Agudini making a run. Able to chest it down, and here's a chance now. Agudini running in the box. Taps that through to Gori. Yes! Thank you. Simon Gori able to get that away goal in the 17th minute. Great setup by Sidney Agudini, who has just come alive in the second half of the season. Has a run from Vera. Vera is through. Vera to Gori. Corey. Flips that up. Ajdini. Oh, yes! Yes! Gorey returns the favor and floats a beautiful pass to Ajdini, who hits it off the half volley. That might be his patented shot, the half volley goal. And Sydney Ajdini gets us our clear and concise second goal, our second away goal. They're going to have to score four goals to get through. I think Tottenham are done. Start of the second half here, and here's how it goes. If we do end up going to the Champions League final, the next episode will be the last episode of U Squad Gods with Bayern Munich 2. I mean, it's most likely that it will be the last episode, as we will go to the Champions League final. And that means if we end up not winning the Bundesliga title, then that's how it's going to be. Cross the box, we'll find Sar. Sar finds Marsh. Marsh looking for a pass on the inside. It will find... what's this guy's name again? Knowles? Foles? Bowles? We'll find the feet of Jack Rolls. So in the 85th minute, Tottenham do get a goal back, but they need three more. Looking to find one last consolation goal as Graf will clear it out. And we have punched ourselves a ticket into the Champions League final. Yes, an action-packed first half. Goal by Gorey. Goal by Ajdini. Both of them helping each other out. The stage is set. Bayern Munich will be taking on Barcelona in the Champions League final. For the third game of the episode, it's the biggest Der Klassiker yet, as Bayern Munich take on Dortmund, and whoever wins will be that much closer to winning the Bundesliga title. All right, what we have going for us at the moment is that RB Leipzig do play Wolfsburg. So if RB Leipzig can at least draw against Wolfsburg and maybe get a win. Actually, I don't want them to win. If they can both draw, that'd be good. Because with a victory, we would boost over both of them. Yep, that's the table right now. And just because of the goal difference, that's what's got us so screwed. Even though we are 44 goals up, everyone else is even higher. Open. Okay, Anderson with the space. He's going to take it. Going against Ramos. He does have the pace over him. Here we go. Anderson flips that up. Taps it to Gorey. Gorey knocks it down and scores! Yes! Simon Gorey! Woo-wee! Thank you. 38th minute. It is Simon Gorey knocking in his 40th goal on the season. He has broken the channel's record for most goals in a season. And what a pass. What great vision by John Anderson to find our Italian striker as Gorey buries that into the bottom left corner. Got ourselves the lead. Troipa, nope, not going to get it. So we'll be cleared up by Lopez. And that will be the end of the first half here. Great goal by Gorey. We do have the victory, but now I'm going to quickly cut through all this and see that result for the, where is it? Okay, Wolfsburg up by one. Leipzig did score, so it's 2-1 Wolfsburg. Again, if they do win, this effort's all for naught, and they will be Bundesliga champions. Oh, keep it, Cristea. All right, good job, Cristea. Dudzinski now. Through ball, Gorey. Gorey curls. Fire scores! Yes! Simon Gorey with a brace. Able to get that one past Pavlenka. Again, we can't control the Wolfsburg RB Leipzig game, but we can sure as hell control this one. Gorey getting the pass from Dudzinski. Once again, that connection coming in clutch. We have a good, firm grip on this game at the moment. We're just going to continue to pour it on here. It's now Gorey. Oh, damn it, they scored a third one. And as Dudzinski scores that beautiful goal, I want to celebrate it. It's a beauty, but Wolfsburg get goal number three. And most likely we are not going to win this Bundesliga title as Gorey does find Dudzinski. I wasn't even trying to shoot it. I heard the news and I was like, God damn it, just press the circle in accident. So Gorey scoring a beautiful goal at the top of the arc. Does hit off the back of the heel of that defender. But hey, I mean, at least we're beating a rival at this point. I feel good in that. So they will get a consolation goal here in stoppage time. Ronnie Lopez able to get the rebound. I mean, it's not going to mean much at this point. So that will be the end of the game. We do beat Borussia Dortmund handedly as we are celebrating, probably because we got Champions League. Pretty sure of that. There is Simon Gori, handful for defenders. He surely was. Two goals on the day. Good result from him. Again, he's having an MVP season. And if the result stays what I thought it was with that Wolfsburg-RB Leipzig game, it's going to be a little bittersweet performance. So now we're going to quit out of here and see the score. Did stay 3-1 Wolfsburg. So with that, they are indeed Bundesliga champions. Congrats to them. A near perfect season. I think they only got two losses. So yeah, there's no way we're going to come back from that. At this point, there's only one thing to do, and that's win. It's Bayern Munich against Wolfsburg at Allianz Arena. I'm going to spare you guys the 3 minutes of highlights, which there were none in this game as we did draw against Wolfsburg 0-0, the final game of the season. Could have been a game of some payback, a little bit of vengeance on our side, but the boys were just too downtrodden with the result. To finish off the season, we'll take a look at the season awards, and wow, David wins player of the competition. Bullshit. That is complete bullshit. Yeah, they won the league, but Gori did numbers this year. Numbers on numbers. We'll take a look at goalkeeper of the tournament. It was Donnarumma of RB Leipzig. He was pretty good. He did have the most clean sheets. Simon Gori does win the Golden Boot with 30 Bundesliga goals on the season. Good job to him. And then the team of the competition. So we do have Dudzinski. And we have Gori. That's it. Two players on the team of the competition. No Dudzinski, the dude. No Anderson, no Petroipa. Wow, that kind of sucks. We'll take a look at the stats. I feel like they'd tell a different story. Has Dudzinski 15 goals, 32 appearances. Gori 30 goals, 32 appearances. Any stragglers? Nope. Then we go to assists. Dudzinski with 11 on the season. Anderson with 10. He had himself a good season as well. Petroipa in 15th with 8. And also Gori with 8. So a good performance by all of them. Dudzinski, baby Dudzinski, was in 3rd with 13 clean sheets in 34 matches. So at least we have ourselves an interesting finale as we get to take on the team that took our Bundesliga title in the Deutsche Pokal. It's our job to win again. It's our job to win our second Deutsche Pokal against Wolfsburg. Again, playing for pride. We'll have to do a lot better than the recent match that we had. And then, of course, the game of all games. The Champions League final against Barcelona. What better way to finish off a save against a team like Barcelona? Barcelona, Bayern Munich, great Champions League final. So yes, this will be the end of the episode. I hope you enjoyed watching as much as I did playing it. Be sure to like it, subscribe, and I will see you next time. This has been Bear Hams, and as always, toodaloo.